Good evening. My name is Steve Aiello, president of Lynchburg Pops Community Band, and it's my privilege to welcome you on behalf of the board of directors and the musicians in the band to this Sousa Spectacular. Now it's on. To honor his legacy and to make some history of our own. Although the band was founded in 2020 due to COVID, we did not have our first concert until April of last year. And what an incredible year of growth it has been. Tonight we are thrilled and humbled to be playing in this beautiful historic facility. Please remember to silence your phones and be sure you're familiar with the location of the exits. We are immensely grateful to Lynchburg American Legion Post 16 for providing major funding for tonight's concert, which allowed us to keep ticket prices low. But we are even more grateful for the men and women represented by this organization who answered the call to duty and served in the military. Thank you. And we want tonight's concert to be a special tribute to those who gave their lives for our freedom. Please note that there is a card in your program that will help us tailor our advertising for future programs and hopefully reach even more people with our goal of providing performing opportunities for local musicians and performances that please, educate, and inspire our audiences. Please take a moment to tick the appropriate boxes and leave it on the table in the lobby as you leave, or complete the survey online using the QR code printed on the card and in the program. And now, please join me in welcoming our Master of Ceremonies for this evening's performance, Band Director at Jefferson Forest High School, Mr. David Webb.
Thank you very much and good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome to the stage Maestro Jim Meredith and your Lynchburg Pops Community Band. Please rise as you are able as American Legion Post 16 presents the colors of the United States of America. And please join the Lynchburg Pops Community Band and sing along as they perform our national anthem, the Star-Spangled Banner. On March 1st, 1922, the John Philip Sousa Band performed on this very stage. There's no record of their performance, but one can only imagine the marches and other music that was played. Now, surprisingly, it was not the Stars and Stripes Forever that launched Sousa to worldwide fame. It's the march we're going to play for you now. In 1889, before the formation of Sousa Band, when he was still the director of the United States Marine Band, The proprietors of the Washington Post newspaper invited Sousa to compose a march for a children's essay competition. Regretting it later, Sousa sold the rights to the march for $35, but the publishers made a fortune. Ladies and gentlemen, the Washington Post March. Similar to the band you see on stage tonight, the Sousa Band was made up of all manner of brass and percussion and woodwind instruments and featured many of the finest musicians in the world, as the allure of traveling the world and playing to sold-out audiences everywhere was very tempting for those musicians. Sousa's concerts always featured the classics. In that tradition, the Pops would like to play for you Franz von Suppe's Rollicking Light Cavalry Overture.
Thank you.
From November 21, 1921 through April 1, 1922, the Sousa Band performed 140 concerts in California, Texas, Louisiana, Florida, Cuba, Georgia, and the Carolinas, and throughout the Mid-Atlantic. In that era, the average American did not own phonographs or radios, so live music was highly sought after. The next march we're going to play dates from 1878 as one of John Philip Sousa's oldest, Esprit de Corps. Sousa's bands always featured a variety of music, more than just marches. From 1920s through the 1930s, one of Sousa's contemporaries was the great jazz artist and composer Duke Ellington. Please join me in welcoming to the stage associate conductor of the Pops band, Steve Williams, to lead the band in Calvin Custer's Duke Ellington. From 1921 through 22, the 1921-22 tour featured soloist of the Sousa Band was none other than outstanding flautist Meredith Wilson. If that name sounds familiar, it is Wilson who gave us The Music Man. The Music Man was based in part on Meredith Wilson's experiences with the Sousa Band, and it's amazing to consider that for one magical night, we had two icons of 20th century music on this very stage. To recognize Meredith Wilson, the next piece will feature the flutes of the Lynchburg Pops, including Bonnie Brunner on alto flute. Julie Giroux is one of the most respected contemporary wind band composers. Her piece, The Bonsai Tree, conjures images from the beautiful country of Japan. Ladies and gentlemen, The Bonsai Tree by Julie Giroux.
Thank you.
Sammy Davis Jr. was an American icon. He was a singer, dancer, actor, comedian, producer, and television director. Throughout the 60s, 70s, and 80s, his concerts in Las Vegas and elsewhere were typically sold-out events, and many of his songs have achieved iconic status. If you were at our Christmas concert, you know that vocalist Daryl Duff was a huge hit. The Pops have invited Daryl back tonight to sing for you a Sammy Davis Jr. melody. Ladies and gentlemen, Daryl Duff.
Just once in a lifetime, a man knows a moment, one wonderful moment, when fate takes his hand, and this is my moment. My destiny's called me, and I'm gonna do great things. Who can take the sunrise? With chocolate and the miracle art to the Candyman. The Candyman can. The Candyman can, cause he mixes it with love to make the world taste good. Oh, the Candyman makes everything he makes satisfying and delicious. Well, you talk about your childhood wishes, and you can even eat the dishes. Oh, oh, you say tomorrow and dip it in a dream. Separate the sorrow and collect up all the grain. The Candyman, the Candyman can. The Candyman can, cause he mixes it with love to make the world taste good. He'll make your world taste good. I knew a man, Bojangles, he would dance for you. Worn out shoes, with silver hair, ragged shirt, and baggy pants. He would do the old soft shoe. He could jump so high, he jumped so high. And then he'd lightly touch down. Mr. Bojangles. That was Mr. Bojangles. That was Mr. Bojangles. A man could dance. Thank you. whether I'm right or whether I'm wrong. If I can find my place in this world or never belong, I gotta be me. I gotta be me. What else can I be but what I am? That far away place, it's the world of success, and it's waiting for me. If I'll just heed the call, oh, I won't settle down nor settle for less. If there's a chance that I can do it, I can have it all. By nobody else. If I'm not right for me, I gotta be free. I gotta be me. I'm willing to try, but do or die. I gotta be me. I gotta be me. I'm gonna build a mountain from a little hill. I'm gonna build a mountain, at least I hope I will. I'm gonna build a mountain, gonna build it way high. And I don't know how I'm gonna do it, I only know I'm gonna try. I'm gonna build me a heaven from a little hell. I'm gonna build me a heaven, and I know darn well I've got two fine young sons who can take my place. I will leave my sons in this heaven on earth with the good Lord's grace. What kind of fool am I, who never fell in love? It seems that I'm the only one that I've been thinking of. What kind of man is this that would not see what could be seen by everybody else but me? What kind of lips are these that lie with every kiss? They whispered empty words, words of love that's left me alone like this. Why can't I fall in love like any other man? And maybe then I'll know what kind of a fool I am. What kind of clown am I? What do I know of life? Why can't I cast away this mask of clay and live my life? Why can't I fall in love
Having fun? Without question, John Philip Sousa was the eminent conductor of his era, but he was not the only one. Composer and conductor Edward Eugene Bagley also toured with his band, and it was on a train while on tour in 1902, that he wrote National Emblem March in his sleeper car. Becoming frustrated with the ending, he tossed the manuscript into a wastebasket. Some band members retrieved it, and the band practiced it secretly in the baggage car. Just before going on stage for the next concert, band members informed Bagley that he would be conducting his National Emblem March that night, and the rest is history. When asked to name the top three significant marches of the era, Sousa listed two of his own and the one you're going to hear, E.E. Bagley's National Emblem March. We welcome to the stage the fabulous Lynchburg Pops singers to join us for our next three selections. Composer John Williams is a living legend. Last month, he turned 91 and is still going as strong as ever. From the outstanding World War II film, Saving Private Ryan, we give you now John Williams' tribute to America's fallen heroes. Ladies and gentlemen, Hymn to the Fallen. I hope you'll forgive my indulgence for standing out here. I wanted to hear that one from out front with you. John Philip Sousa was a conductor of the United States Marine Band, and even after he left the Marines to form his own band, his programs were filled with patriotic music. In recognition of American Legion Post 16 and their contributions to this evening's event, and to celebrate our country, we offer you now Carmen Dragon's beautiful arrangement of Samuel Augustus Ward's America the Beautiful. Are you now, or were you ever, a member of our nation's armed forces? If so, we want to gratefully recognize your service. The United States Armed Service Salute, or excuse me, Armed Forces Salute, features the five original songs for our fighting forces. As you hear the song of your branch of the service, please rise and let us honor you. Before I announce the band's final number, I'd like to ask representatives from American Legion Post 16 to come to the stage for a special presentation. I'll also ask Jim Meredith and Steve Aiello to join us. Stop taking pictures, Steve. Come over here. The American Legion Post 16 would like to give certificates of appreciation to both these gentlemen. I'll read you the inscription on each. Presented to Maestro James R. Meredith, conductor of Lynchburg Pops Community Band, for your vision and dedication in making the Lynchburg Pops Community Band a reality, and for your talent and leadership as conductor, your tremendous effort, patience, and focus on the musicians combined to make the band a wonderful gift to the community. Presented by Lynchburg Post 16, Department of Virginia, this first day of March, 2023. Jim? And to James A. Aiello, President, Lynchburg Pops Community Band, for your vision, energy, and commitment in organizing and managing the Lynchburg Pops Community Band. Your devotion and attention to detail have contributed immensely to the band's success and to making its performances a wonderful gift to the community. Presented by Lynchburg Post 16, Department of Virginia, this first day of March, 2023. Steve?
Interrupt this for a minute. We got one more thing we gonna do here. So, first of all, American Legion Post 16 would like to thank everyone for being here. We'd like to thank the Academy for this opportunity. And most of all, we'd like to thank these wonderful musicians. We also want to recognize particular one of these musicians, Charles Michael Reeves. Would you stand up, please? Mike is a very honored member of our post, and he's a member of the Honor Guard. If any in Lynchburg is familiar with the Honor Guard, we present honors for deceased veterans and their families, recognizing them. Mike performs taps at many of these funerals for us, and we love having him. He also does plays taps at community events and other music, actually, but he plays at Old City Cemetery and down at Monument Terrace. So, Mike, we have a certificate for you also. I'm going to read it now. Citation for meritorious service for years of selfless service to the community, state, and nation as a leading veterans advocate through his leadership in the American Legion and the Military Order of the World Wars. Charles Michael Reeves is awarded this citation in recognition thereof by Lynchburg Post 16, Department of Virginia, the American Legion, this first day of March, 2023.
We're announcing our encore from the stage. What would a Sousa concert be without the Stars and Stripes Forever? It is quite possible that the last time America's official march was played in this building was on March 1st, 1922, under the leadership of John Philip Sousa himself. Tonight, Jim Meredith and the Pops Band want you to relive that magical moment of that evening. 101 years ago tonight, concertgoers in Lynchburg heard this very tune. Ladies and gentlemen, the Stars and Stripes Forever. Thank you.
Thank you.